यस मैम।
हाँ, सो टुडे विल स्टार्ट विथ कंडक्शन एंड ब्रेक डाउन इन द लिक्विड डाइइलेक्ट्रिक्स. So liquid dielectrics, because of their inherent properties, appear as though they would be more useful in insulating materials than either solids or gases. Okay, so if we talk about the liquid dielectrics, these are used mainly spreading through in high voltage cables. Okay, you are aware of this? Where have you seen the liquid dielectrics? Yes, have you ever used liquid dielectrics? Have you ever come across where you have used the liquid dielectrics, liquid insulator? Anyone? Sanya,
यस मैम।
एनी आइडिया? सिरी?
मैम ट्रांसफॉर्मर ऑयल।
हाँ, ट्रांसफॉर्मर ऑयल इज द बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल. अदर देन ट्रांसफॉर्मर ऑयल, अदर देन ट्रांसफॉर्मर ऑयल, हैव यू एवर कम अक्रॉस एनी लिक्विड डाइइलेक्ट्रिक यूज्ड इन एनी ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिकल एप्लीकेशन? भूमिका?
स्विच गियर ऑल्सो मैम लिक्विड इलेक्ट्रिक्स में भी यूज।
स्विच गियर में विच वन, विच स्विच गियर? विच स्विच गियर?
हाई वोल्टेज स्विच गियर अकॉर्डिंग टू विकिपीडिया।
वाह, यू ऑल आर ओपनिंग द गूगल. कौन था ये?
नो मैम, नो मैम, नो.
राइट. ओके, अभी सी इफ यू टॉक अबाउट स्विच गियर, स्विच गियर अभी यू हैव द सब्जेक्ट. ओके, वॉट ऑल आर द स्विच गियर्स? यू हैव फ्यूजेस. ठीक है, स्विचेस आर स्विच गियर्स, रिलेज आर स्विच गियर्स, सर्किट ब्रेकर्स आर स्विच गियर्स. तो विच स्विच गियर आर यू टॉकिंग अबाउट? Which switch gear are you talking about?
Circuit breakers, ma'am.
It is a circuit breakers, right? In circuit breakers, you know the classification, right? You have something called, you know, something called as liquid circuit breaker. Okay, vacuum circuit breakers are there. Minimum oil circuit breaker is there. Okay, oil circuit breakers are there. So, oil is nothing but a liquid dielectric. Okay. So, because of the what I have written here, because of its inherent properties, okay, why we call it as inherent properties? Why we call what is that inherent property? See what statement I have written here. They would be more useful as insulating materials than either solids or gases. Okay, this is because of its inherent property, which we call as its density. Okay, because both liquids and solids, if I talk as compared with gases, are 10 power 3 times denser. Okay, so that is why we see liquid and solid dielectrics above gas. Okay, also liquids like gases fill the complete volume to be insulated and simultaneously will dissipate heat by convention. So with this sentence, you are clear with this sentence, because we use transformer oil, okay, which acts as a insulating medium. Also, it acts as a coolant. You all are aware of this fact, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, So this is what about, this is why I have said liquid, because of its inherent properties, can be seen to be used above solids or gases. Okay. These two points are clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, although liquids are expected to give very high dielectric strength of the order of 10 megavolts per centimeter, in actual practice, the strengths obtained are only of the order of 100 kilovolt per centimeter. Okay. If you talk about the oil, okay, liquid, okay, liquid insulator, one is your oil. So oil is about 10 times more efficient. Okay, if you compare it with, I said we compare it with gases, okay, like air or nitrogen, right? And it's, so because of this, the oil's heat transfer capability is used in the transformer, okay? So even though it, you know, you can expect it to be in order of 10 megavolt per centimeter, but in practice, till now, what we have obtained is the dielectric strength of only 100 kilovolt per centimeter. Okay, so now talking about the uses where we use. Okay, so as we say, liquid dielectrics are mainly used as impregnates in high voltage cables. If you remember, in fourth semester, transmission and distribution, underground cables we had studied, correct? There we had seen the oil is used as an insulator, right? Cables and capacitors, and for filling up transformers, circuit breakers, etc. Okay, so these are the areas where we use the liquid dielectrics. Okay. So liquid dielectrics also act as a heat transformer agents, as you all are aware, in the transformers. And as a, in circuit breakers, you said, what is its function in circuit breaker? What is the function of insulator in a circuit breaker?
Absorbing heat, ma'am, after short circuiting and all.
Anyone else?
Heat transfer agents.
Heat transfer.
Arc quenching.
Yes, who said this?
Arc quenching, ma'am.
Who said this?
Ma'am, me, Hina.
Yeah, correct, right? It is a, see, circuit breakers, important work. Why we require circuit breakers is to quench the arc. Okay, circuit break, else we would have used fuses, right? Above fuses, we are using circuit breakers, right? Because they can automatically restore the working condition. So to restore the working condition, that arc quenching is necessary. Okay, so these liquid dielectrics, it all, you know, in apart from heat transfer agents in the transformers, it acts as an arc quenching media also in the circuit breakers. Okay, so if I want to specify the petroleum oils, okay, the transformer oil which you have you are aware of, transformer oils used in the transformer tank, okay, these are the petroleum oils. Okay, and these are most commonly used as a liquid dielectrics. Okay, understood up till here? Clear up till here, everyone? So, So liquid dielectrics normally are the mixtures of hydrocarbons and are weakly polarized. Okay. So, if I want to use this liquid dielectric for the electrical insulation purpose, right, first an important thing here is they should be free from moisture. Okay, as we know, water is a good conductor. So, my insulator should be free of moisture. Next is products of oxidation and other contaminants should not be there. Okay, So these are some of the requirements if I want to use the liquid dielectrics as a insulating medium. Okay. One more important factor that affects the electrical strength, okay, of insulating oil, as I said, moisture. Okay, is the presence of water. Moisture is nothing but presence of water in the form of fine droplets, okay, suspended in the oil. Sometimes you cannot see, but it is there. Okay, so if that is there, okay, the presence of even 0.01%, you all are able to understand what I'm telling?
Yes, ma'am.
So the presence of even 0.01% of water in the transformer oil reduces its electrical strength to 20%. Samajh mein aaya? So that is the impact of moisture content or the suspended water droplet, okay, in the dry oil. Okay, clear up till here? So this thing, right, that's what I have mentioned here. Okay, even 0.1% of suspended fine droplets of water will reduce the insulator's electrical strength by 20% of the dry oil value. It means dry oil is capable of having more breakdown strength as compared to the dielectric having the moisture content. Understood up till here, everyone?
And what is dry oil value?
Dry oil, see, it depends. It is different for different liquids. Okay, dry oil is, for the time being, you understand, it is the oil which is totally dry. Dry means it is not having any water droplet.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, you are asking about dry oil value. Correct? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
See, there is nothing called as dry oil. Dry oil matlab, see, there's no difference like dry oil or wet oil. Dry oil, why we have mentioned here, is this is the oil which is pure, which is having pure hydrocarbon. See, this is not having, dry oil will not have even 0.00001% of water content. समझ में आया? Is that understood? Right? So don't think that dry oil and wet oil. Wet oil बने से गीला होता है. Dry oil is the, you know, it's not like that. Dry oil is not having the water content. That is why it's called as a dry oil, pure hydrocarbon. Okay? Fine with this?
Okay, ma'am.
Shall we proceed? Okay, so now when we know what is meant by dry oil and we know that there are some characteristics of dielectrics to be used as an insulator. Okay, so what are the characteristics? See, one thing is just now I said there should be no water content. Okay, this is a well-known fact. What others would be the characteristics of liquid dielectrics? Yes?
Higher dielectric strength.
Yes. So first thing is it should have good dielectric properties. Okay. Next.
Environmental friendly.
Environmental friendly means it should not have water content. Okay. Just like gaseous insulators. As dry it is, more will be its breakdown strength. Okay. Next. See, this dielectric properties, what I have, I'm speaking here, we talk about the dielectric strength. Okay. So this dielectric strength depends on the type of liquid.
Low viscosity.
Huh? Hello?
Ma'am, chemical is stability.
Yes. So, yes. It has to be chemically stable. Okay. So, first talking about this dielectric property. Okay. I'm talking about its dielectric strength. Okay. So, dielectric strength depends on the particular liquid you are choosing for a given application. Okay. So, this dielectric strength basically depends on...
Low viscosity, ma'am.
Sorry? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so first one is dielectric properties. So this dielectric properties means dielectric strength, okay, which depends on the atomic and the molecular properties of the liquid itself. Okay? Next, someone said me, So one of you said the chemical stable. Okay, it should be chemically stable. Okay, what do you mean by chemical stability? What do you mean by chemical stability?
It should.
Right. I cannot hear you, but okay. Let me. Not with other chemicals. See, even if you are talking about the liquid dielectric, transformer itself you take. Okay, transformer may, there are windings, okay, and the solid dielectrics between a HV and the LV. So my liquid insulator, which I am using, should not react with these things. Okay, it should, these either or singly or in combination, okay, it should not cause degradation. समझ में आया? So degrade हुआ तो क्या होगा? The solid, degrade हुआ तो gaseous products are formed. Okay, because of which the corrosion occurs, impairment of heat transfer occurs. Okay, deterioration of electrical properties takes place. Okay, dielectric losses will increase. Okay, arcing will increase, discharges will increase. समझ में आ रहा है? Understanding what is meant by chemical stability? Right, in simple words, oxidation and corrosion should not occur with the surrounding medium. Okay, let it be solid insulator, let it be the electrodes, right? It should not react with these things. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then next one is it should have excellent heat transfer. Transformer character, heat transfer characteristics we need because the simplest example is your transformer. If a short circuit occurs, right, and if my transformer oil is not capable of removing the heat, right, then the temperature of the whole tank goes up. Okay, so that is why the dielectric which we are using should have excellent heat transfer characteristics. Is it understood up till here?
Yes, ma'am.
Right? Okay. Now, these are your general factors. Okay, now I'm using this, I want to use this dielectric, you know, for my high voltage. Correct? So, what should be other important characteristics? See, these three are my general characteristics, okay? What are specific characteristics? See, you have to take care of its electrical properties also. Okay, what are its electrical properties? You need to take care. Which electrical properties am I talking about?
Ma'am, resistivity.
Yes, resistivity. Okay, so you all are aware, right? Insulator means it should have good resistivity. Then only I can use it as an insulator. Okay, then what else? One is resistivity, no doubt. Next. Have you heard about relative permittivity?
Viscosity, ma'am.
Have you heard about... Sorry? Have you heard about the permittivity?
Viscosity.
Yes, the viscosity of the liquid which you are using. Okay, have you heard, now talking about this relative permittivity. Okay, what is relative permittivity? Any idea what is relative permittivity?
Permittivity of the liquid we are using in comparison with the another liquid or as a standard value.
Oh, permittivity, what do you mean by, what does it describe if I talk about relative permittivity? What does it describe? Okay, see, relative permittivity, okay, if you specify it, it specifies the ability to polarize a material subjected to electric field. Samajh mein aaya? What is relative permittivity? I have not told you the definition. I told you what does it specify. It specifies the ability to polarize a material. Understanding? You understand the meaning of polarize a material? Yes, check in the chat box. Okay, ability to polarize a material subjected to an electric field. Okay, described by the permittivity. Okay, is this understood? Let me proceed now. So, see, as I said, electrical properties which plays a major role are relative permittivity, the resistivity, okay, then there comes something called as a loss tangent or tan delta, okay, here it should be tan delta, okay, or its power factor, which is an indication of power loss under AC voltage application, okay, this we will see as we go ahead. Okay. Next is, okay, next is the ability to withstand high electric stresses. How much capable is my liquid dielectric to withstand the electric stresses? Okay, these are the major electrical properties a liquid dielectric should possess to be used as a insulator in the high voltage engineering. Is that clear?
Yes.
Up to here, is that understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Right? Okay. Now, when we talk about liquid dielectrics, okay, there are two types of liquids. One is pure liquid and one is commercial liquid. Okay, so pure liquids, what are pure liquids? See, pure liquids are those which are chemically pure and do not contain any other impurity, even in traces of 1 in 10 power 9. Okay, it's not 109, it is 10 power 9 and are structurally simple. Okay, so pure liquids are the liquids which are chemically pure and simple. Okay, so examples of such pure liquids can be N-hexane, N-heptane and other paraffin hydrocarbons. Is it understood? Understood?
Yes.
What do you mean by pure liquids?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, when we talk about pure liquids, by using these simple and pure liquids, it is easier to separate out various factors, what we have seen till now, that influence the conduction and breakdown in them. Okay. But when we talk about the commercial liquids, okay, commercial liquids are the oils which are not chemically pure. Okay. So normally consists of mixtures of complex organic molecules, right? For example, benzene, okay, which cannot be easily specified or reproduced in a series of experiment. Okay, these are my commercial liquids. Commercial liquids are, you know, are complex in structures. Okay, up till here, was it understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now talking about breakdown in the liquid dielectrics. So see, when we are studying breakdown in liquid dielectrics, we need to study how the conduction and breakdown takes place in a pure liquid and the breakdown process in the commercial liquids. Okay, two types we need to study, right? So first we'll see what are the factors that affect the breakdown strength of the liquid dielectrics. Why I have mentioned okay, so this environment is an external factor. Okay, that will cover it here. Right? So, first thing is electrode configuration. This I have shown you for the gaseous dielectrics in our HV lab. I had shown you. What about the electrode configurations, right? Configuration, uniform or non-uniform, point to point, sphere to sphere, or sphere to point is your non-uniform. Okay, this is all about the electrode configuration. Then we dealt with electrode surface finish. Okay, how the smooth surface affects as compared to the uneven surface. Okay. Then the type of voltage, okay, whether you are using HVAC or HVDC, okay, period of application and magnitude, okay, how much voltage you are applying is your magnitude and period of application. At this point of time, what is its temperature, what is its pressure? Okay, then purity of the liquid, so purification of the liquid, and the aging condition. Okay, now see, aging condition means how old the liquid is. Okay, the liquid as it grows older and older changes its color. Okay, it go on, see, initially pure liquid, you know, the fresh liquid will be it will be almost light yellow, lightish yellow in color, right? As it goes on aging, that yellow becomes dominant. So it becomes yellowish as it grows, as it goes on aging. ठीक है, समझ में आ रहा है? Understanding? So this is the visual test you can see if you see a liquid insulator, whether it is a fresh liquid or it is a aged liquid. You can have a visual bifurcation between this. Up till here, am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Right? Now, talking about conduction and breakdown in pure liquids. Okay, so when the low electric fields less than 1 kilovolt per centimeter are applied, conductivities of 10 to 20 mo per centimeter are obtained. See, conductivities of 10 to 20 mos, right? What I mean is 10 to 10 power minus 20 mos are obtained. Okay, mos per centimeter are obtained. Okay, so these are probably due to the impurities remaining after purification. Okay, now see, you all know that if you take out the petrol from the ground, like the natural petrol, you need to go for purification. Okay, so that the impurities like dust, moisture, or dissolved gas rehta hai, some ionic impurities will be there. Okay, we need to remove this. Okay, so various methods are employed for purification. Right? Are you aware of the process for purification? Which are the processes for purification of liquid dielectrics? For example, petrol hi le lo.
Distillation, centrifugation.
Centrifugation is there. Okay. Distillation is there. Okay. So we can go for chemical treatment. Okay, see, do you all remember the curve? See, am I audible now?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, right? See, here I have said, however, the third line you see. However, when the fields are high, greater than 100 kilovolt per centimeter, the currents not only increase rapidly, but also undergo violent fluctuations which will die down after some time. ठीक है, you all are here?
Yes, ma'am.
See, from this statement, you can recall the curve which I had shown you, where I explained you the ohmic region, the saturation region, and the Townsend's discharge region. Okay, I had shown you the current growth curve. Do you remember that curve?
Yes,
remember that curve. Okay, so it is a similar type of curve. Okay, so you can recall that curve for the pure liquids also. The exact mechanism of current growth in pure liquids, okay, is not known. Okay, see, there are many theories available for commercial liquids, okay, but for pure liquids the current growth is not known. Exact mechanism of current growth is not known. Okay, however, it appears that the electrons are generated from the cathode by field emission of electrons, right? The electrons so liberated get multiplied by a process similar to Townsend's primary and secondary ionization. Okay, only this thing is known, right? So if I show you the curve, okay, so you can, right, the figure below shows a variation of current as a function of electric field, okay, for the hexane. Okay, so I said you hexane, n-hexane is a pure liquid. Okay, so this figure shows you the variation of electric field. Okay, this is your conduction current, right, this is your electric field. Okay, this is for a hexane. Okay, now this condition is almost nearer to breakdown. Okay, at this condition almost the breakdown occurs in a pure dielectric. Okay, however, if now, you know, if I want to redraw this figure where I'll start from here, okay, from very small current, see, I have not considered these small currents. Okay, if I consider these small currents, you can again see the same curve. Okay, see, now you recall, right, in gases this was the ohmic region, this was ohmic region, correct, this was saturation region, and this was Townsend's discharge region. Okay, so similar to our breakdown in gases, Townsend's curve I had shown you, here also this curve will have three distinct regions. Okay, one is initially linear or ionic region, okay, where at very low fields the current is due to dissociation of ions. So this region, what I have mentioned here, linear, can also be termed as ionic region because of dissociation of ions. Okay, am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, next, with the intermediate fields, okay, these are my intermediate fields, right, the current reaches a saturation value. Okay, so this is my saturation region. Okay, and at high fields the current generated is because of the field aided electron emission from the cathode gets multiplied in the liquid. Okay, similar to a Townsend mechanism. Okay, so Townsend mechanism is important because breakdown in pure liquids derive their base from the Townsend's theory, which is actually for the gases. Okay, am I clear up till here?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, so In pure liquids, we do not have any exact theory known which causes the breakdown or conduction and the breakdown. Okay, in pure liquids, it is not known till now. Okay, however, if you talk about, see, pure liquids, so we get very less. Okay, these are ideal liquids, we get it very less. So the liquids which we use in our transformer and the cables are the commercial liquids. Okay, so there are some proved theories which supports conduction and breakdown in the commercial liquids. Okay, but today, that we'll do it in tomorrow's class. But today what we have done is breakdown and conduction in the liquid dielectrics, pure liquid dielectrics. Okay, so as such, as I mentioned, see, the exact mechanism of current growth is not known. Right, so when you are supposed to when you are asked to explain, you are explaining the same conduction current graph which we do for the Townsend's current growth of the gases. Am I clear for today?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so we'll continue for the continue with the conduction and breakdown of commercial liquids in the Wednesday's class, Wednesday or Thursday's class. Okay, so we all will quit now. You all can quit now.